Commissioner Gaerlan, no, you were saying about how everyone needs to adapt, no? That it's not just about, you know, we cannot continue, no, with this kind of lifestyle, no? So, sabi mo nga, di ba? As individuals, whether we like it or not, we have a carbon footprint, no? Paghinga nga lang, meron na, no? And then you mentioned government has this, needs to act on this particular aspect, as the private sector also needs to balance its, ano, no, its views on development. Pero yung ano, how can government, the private sector, and the public, no, contribute towards lowering emissions? Especially, it's a critical issue. We're feeling its impact na eh, di ba? So, you know, definitely the public can only do so much, no, lower consumption. But how can the government and the private sector help, no, the public towards leading more, sabi na, more sustainable, more ecologically friendly lifestyles? No?
Well, alam mo, the public is, sabi na natin, aware sila and they're willing to, change, you know, contribute. Talking, for example, about solar or renewable energy. So, ako, as an individual, isipin ko, mahal yan. How can I afford that? And then you're telling me to use that. So, there's now an opportunity, unahin natin si private sector, for the public to be recipients of this type of technologies. Ano, itong mga solar na to. So, eto nga, let me tell you about a story. Nung minsan, nagkwento nga kami ni former Mayor Bistek.
Herbert.
Herbert Bautista. And we were discussing about yung solar nga. So, sabi ko sa kanya, ako, meron na akong solar sa bahay. Mm. I can power my own home. Mm. But that was my expense. Mm. Sabi ko, paano ngayon yung mga ibang gusto mag-solar? Mm. What now can you provide them as incentive? Mm-mm. Sabi niya, oh, pwede kong bigyan ng ano yan, ng discount sa real estate tax. Mm-mm. Or sa, ano ba yung tawag doon? A milyar?
Real estate tax.
Real estate tax. Oh, okay. Pwede ko pang bigyan ng ano yan, aside from the early bird na 20%, pwede ko pang bigyan ng real estate tax discount yan. Mm-mm. Tapos, my second question was, wala namang bawal. Mm. Tama? Sabi ko sa kanya. Yes. Any home, any house, can have a choice of his, her own power source. Mm. So sabi ko, ang ganda niyan. So, anyway, kung may discount na, mahal pa rin. Mm. So, what's the role of the private sector there? If the private sector can provide subsidy doon sa mga households na willing to do that and just, you know, amortize it in small amounts na magkakaroon pa rin sila ng somehow an interest in the payment pero maliit lang na kayang-kaya ng private citizen. Mm. They now help lower now the consumption of fossil fuels and at the same time recover money from it in the form of interest payments. Eh, kausap ko ibang association ng mga private organizations, sinasabi ko sa kanila to na you can provide that subsidy kasi you have a fund, yung corporate social responsibility na inilalabas nyo as an expense. For example, yung clean up ng mga river systems. Sasabihin na, sige, sagot namin yung clean up nitong portion na to. And you do that continuously without any return. So sabi ko, what if you have a return on your money, which is in the form of that? Sabi na, yeah, it's interesting. So all you need to do is do that because wala namang prohibitions for you to do that kasi sa kung gagawin mo sa local you're not dependent on national policy. It's actually the individual's choice to do to set it up in their homes or not. So parang ako noon, nung naglagay ako ng solar, pagbabawalan ba ako ng Meralco? No. So I have the option to use it. So that way, that's a one actually workable option para gumalaw lahat ito, maging ano, maging reality.
Pero nga sir, so you have the private sector, pero paano kaya siya pwedeng i-incentivize ng gobyerno? Kasi the private sector, sabi mo nga, diba, they tend to do things out of may corporate social responsibility, yeah. No, pero on the other hand, no, the private, lalo na, diba sir, we're talking, may conflict of interest kasi yan. For example, si power companies would not want you to do that, yes, diba, yes. Kasi, and definitely kung ako yung nasa public sector, gusto mo ako mag-solar, paano mo siya ibebenta sa akin? Bebentahan mo ako niyan kasi sabihin ko sa iyo, mahal siya ngayon. In the long run, magmumura yan kasi mas liliit yung babayaran mo kay Meralco. So may conflict of interest. No, paano kaya mag-mediate si government niyan? Kasi obviously si Meralco gusto niya kumikita siya. The power companies would want to earn money. Ako, bebentahan mo ako niyan kasi sasabihin ko, ah, makakatipid ako. Na hindi na ako mag-aalala sa brownout. Paano ngayon si gobyerno dyan?
You know, there's actually politics in business. Mm. Ang nakikita namin dito, sige, if you're talking about cities, medyo andyan yung concentration ng politics and business. So what we can do initially as a pilot is we start it with the small island groups.
Mm.
Yung mga small island provinces na okay, we can give the option to the electric cooperatives mismo, sila na. O sige, huwag na tayong mag-introduce ng bagong players. Kayo na mismo, you subsidize this, di ba? Kasi magbabayad din naman sa inyo yan. Or you provide that, maningil kayo ng kuryente sa kanila, pero cheaper. So that can be an option, di ba? Na, sige, ikaw pa rin yung nagne-negosyo dyan, you still provide the electricity. Pero singilin mo naman ang mababayang mga yan. Make it more affordable sa kanila. That's another option. So, kung gusto nilang, or the private sector, kaya gayan si Ayala, is continuously developing, di ba, itong mga islands and even converting them into a resort. O di yung surrounding communities, supplyan ko kayo ng solar, tapos yung same arrangement, bayaran mo ko ng unti-unti. And then, what the local government can do to that is allow them to be able to do that. And then, siguro, give also incentives to the private groups na, bawasan ko rin tax mo. Local tax mo. Something like that.
Pero yun nga, no? Kasi we're talking about homes, no? Pero on the other hand, while you have private homes, eh sino ba yung mas malakas magkonsumo? Kasi I'm willing to bet na pagsamahin ko ang limang mall,
yes,
at ang energy consumption nila, mas malaki yan sa ilang barangay dito sa buong Pilipinas, sa QC lang, for example, no? So, tas syempre, hindi lang yung mga malls, no? We're talking about also schools, no? We're talking about...
Yes.
So, if we're pushing the public, no, in more public citizens, no, to change their lifestyle, change their source, at yung incentive ay makamura, di ba? At least sustainable na to at nakatulong pa sa environment, may push din ba tayo or are there ways that we're pushing? Kasi mas malakas ang emission ng isang mall kaysa sa isang barangay siguro, no? May push din ba tayo sa kanila para magkaroon sila ng o mag-convert sila towards renewable and sustainable energy?
Meron na rin ano yan, renewable energy law na nilalatag doon kung paano yung magiging transition yan, requiring even these big players to, you know,
lower their emissions.
Yes, path, no? And transform their sources to renewable sources na. And it's, again, a matter of implementation. But you know what's good about this is si SM is doing that already. Sa mga malls niya. And
paano sir? Paano nag-
sa mga rooftop?
Sa may mga solar panels?
Yes, meron na. Hindi ko alam exactly anong branch, pero there are about 2 or 3 na solarized na. That's what they call it, solarized na yung kanilang mga mall. So, maganda. And I think Ayala is following suit sa ganyang approach. And even yung other private companies are doing it as well. In fact, Petron in some parts of the yung mga gasoline stations na are also considering that.
So, pero yun nga, di ba? Hindi ba aaray yung... Siyempre, di ba, magre-reklamo yung mga power companies. Bababa ang kita ko. Bababa kung... So, kalimbawa, kahit 50-50 man lang yung arrangement ng bahay mo, personal home lang, no? 50% powered by solar, and then yung hindi niya, yung kunyari, kung gabi na, tapos nag-ano na yung baterya mo, tsaka magkikick in yung, ano, no, yung electric current sa bahay mo, may gano'n, no? So, bababa ang kita nila, no? How does government plan? Kasi, alimbawa, kung maipatupad natin yung proyekto na yan, tatamaan itong mga kumpanyang to. How does government plan? Or ano yung government vision dito?
Yun nga, that has to be worked out. Pero, ano pa yung mga additional developments dyan? San Miguel is now considering to put up a 1 million watt, 1 million megawatt of solar plant.
So sir, just a final question na lang. At nung po medyo complicated din siya, no? So you have the government, ito yung takbo ng government, apparently we're still at the planning and adapting stage, no? So siguro dahil nga din ano, dahil sa current conditions natin, pero if the government is doing that, no, what is expected, or how can the public, you know, and the various groups, organizations, sectors, how can we address this, no? Kasi kung gobyerno lang, syempre, no, that's hindi siya sustainable, no? Pero how can we, the public, no, contribute towards not just adapting, sana hindi nga adapting, 'di ba, addressing and hopefully ano, no, providing a solution to climate change.
Well, it's really a whole of society, a whole of government approach to this. Talaga kaya ng government lang 'to. We need to involve all the sectors, private sectors, NGOs, CSOs, individuals to take the necessary or contributory response to be able to address this whole problem. Number one agenda would be, dapat yan, we reduce carbon footprint. So each and one of us is actually contributing to increasing concentrations of greenhouse gas. Sabi ko nga sa'yo, just by us talking here, we're emitting carbon dioxide. If you go to the toilet, you emit carbon dioxide. Di ba? If you consume food, indirectly, mayroong carbon footprint yan.
Huminga ka lang.
Yes, di ba? The waste you generate is also a footprint for carbon dioxide. Ang ano pa nito, yung other services or goods that would indirectly use or have a carbon footprint, like yung water, for example, you use water, bagong ma-purify yan, may carbon footprint yan. If you use more water, you waste a lot of water, you have more carbon footprint. Di ba? Sa transport naman, masyado kang gala, pasyal ka ng pasyal, gamit ka ng gamit ng kotse, you put in more fuel, and that fuel has a carbon footprint. Plus, the vehicle itself emits carbon dioxide. So, I believe collectively, pag ginawa natin itong mga small efforts na to, it becomes a significant collectively.
Sige, thank you, Engineer Gaerlan. Any final words po before we end the discussion?
Well,
action ba?
Unang-una, I want to thank you for having me here and allowing me to express my emotions, my feelings. But climate change is a reality. In fact, it's another problem that is an offshoot of so many problems before. And like I've told you earlier, the problem is us. So if you're not really aware of that, we need to be aware now that we are causing the problem. And ano ba yung kailangan natin gawin to be able to contribute to improving that or being a solution to that problem. So individually I'm speaking to everybody because it gives an impact if we do it collectively.
Thank you very much, Engineer Ted. So just some final words regarding what, of course, Engineer Gaerlan has already, Commissioner Gaerlan has already discussed. No, climate change is real, no? And sad to say, as of the moment, we're still adapting. No, we still don't have a long-term plan. No, but that doesn't mean that we cannot act. In fact, it is a call for us to act and act immediately. No, and not just on a personal level, but also on a structural, institutional level, in order for us, because it is not just a matter of lifestyle. No, it's a matter of survival. So thank you very much for watching us for this public intellectual lecture series. Thank you very much again, Commissioner Gaerlan, for accommodating us. And we'll see you in the next session.